KVSC Sports Director Ted Leroux here with St. Cloud State Baseball Coach Pat Dolan. Pat, let's start things off before we get into your transfer. Let's start with your kids in the Northwoods League. Really had a good year during the summer, all over the Midwest, it seems. Just touch base on the kids and, you know, how good of prospects they were and how good a season they had in the Northwoods League.
And the Northwoods League just came out with their top prospect list, and amazingly, we had five of our Huskies ranked in the top 200. Carl Sorensen just had a heck of a second half of the season, 38 RBIs in 38 games for Kalamazoo. Eric Luxterkamp, everybody knows about Lux. He was rated the 68th prospect. Jared Harrison, who last year was the 15th rated prospect, he fell down a little bit. And then Michael Giorgella, another one of our senior players, he was ranked in the top 200 as well. So, you know, we're not all that in the rankings, but it is good for those kids. It shows that we have guys in our team that are pro prospects. I've been fortunate to have 31 of our former players signed pro contracts, and 8 of them at St. Cloud State. So it's good for these kids. They had a great summer of baseball. We're giving a couple weeks off here before we start our fall season, and now we'll crank it up again.
Talk about that fall baseball league and what you have going on. What do you like about that so far?
You know, we have a fall baseball league for the young kids in the area, 12th graders all the way down to second graders. We've got over 150 kids signed up for that already. That starts Saturday, September 12th, and runs 5 weeks. For us, we actually start our fall season the middle part of September. Like I said, I wanted to give a lot of the guys some time off, and we have a lot of our guys that are finishing up in the Minnesota Amateur State Tournament too this weekend. So we have a 45-day window that we get 24 practices in, and you know, we kind of separate it through about 3 or 4 times a week all the way up to about the third week in October.
All right, let's talk about your two transfers that are coming into the program. You reached all the way to the Big Ten Conference to get Bo Fendel from the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Talk about him quickly. Both these guys are from Minnesota, but let's focus on Bo.
Yeah, you know, Bo, I've known him since he's 10 years old. His father, Russ Fendel, was a Husky great, played with the Minnesota Twins, and Bo's been coming to our camps and clinics. And he was rated the number one catcher by Perfect Game last year in the state of Minnesota, one of the top five players nominated for Mr. Baseball, and went down to play for Darren Erstad at University of Nebraska last year. And unfortunately, he had some arm problems, had to go through a Tommy John surgery, and he should be ready to go for this spring for us. So he's going to be a high-impact player, and there's nobody that likes baseball as much as Bo Fendel, and nobody that's going to put as much time into his game. And he's definitely a guy that we're really excited about, and we think he's going to be a high-impact player for us. You know, Logan Swan, he was another one of our top recruits all the way. I mean, we started kind of looking at him as a sophomore, and as a junior, you know, he hurt his back, didn't play a lot, but had a great sophomore year, a great senior year. I remember talking to Terry Ryan, the GM with the Minnesota Twins. He brought him in for a pre-draft tryout. And the only two guys that I've recruited that we've signed that went to pre-draft tryouts were Jordan Smith, who ended up signing with the Cleveland Indians in the 9th round, and Logan Swan. And not that I want to compare Logan to Jordan Smith by any means, but he went to that tryout and hit 6 home runs at Target Field. And he's a guy that we really like. I mean, he's very athletic, big football player in high school as well. And, you know, we're expecting big things from him as well.
Last thing, what's an off season like for you? What's a day in the life for Pat Dolan in the fall and winter months when it seems to be pretty cold outside and baseball seems to be pretty far away?
Well, I'm not going to complain one bit. I get paid to get throw up some home babes and hit some fun goals, throw some batting practice, and you know, I think we were at over 300 games this summer. You know, but I get paid to watch baseball games, and it's always something going on, whether it's, you know, we're just right now finalizing our golf tournament. We've got 25 teams signed up for that already. Next thing you know, we'll get our first pitch banquet, our ice fishing tournament. There's always something going on in Husky baseball, and you know, it's all to raise money for our ball players, and it allows us to take those extra trips. We're going to Arkansas again twice this year in February, going down to Arizona, and hopefully looking forward to 2016 when the new Viking stadium's up and running, so we don't have to spend so much time on the road and in the bus.